नमस्कार दोस्तों, आपके और हमारे ऑनलाइन यूट्यूब चैनल नर्सिंग कैरियर क्लब में आप सभी का स्वागत करते हैं। हमें पूरी उम्मीद है कि आप सभी ने हमारा पिछला वीडियो जरूर देखा होगा। यदि किसी कारणवश नहीं देख पाए हैं तो डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में दिए गए लिंक पर क्लिक करें, जरूर देखें। यदि आपको हमारा वीडियो पसंद आता है तो इसे लाइक, सब्सक्राइब एवं शेयर जरूर करें। तो आइए, आज हम बीएससी नर्सिंग फोर्थ ईयर के सब्जेक्ट मिडवाइफरी एंड ऑब्स्टेट्रिकल नर्सिंग के यूनिट सिक्स्थ के बारे में बात करते हैं। हमारा यूनिट सिक्स्थ है जिसका नाम है असेसमेंट एंड मैनेजमेंट ऑफ नॉर्मल न्यूनेट्स। अब असेसमेंट एंड मैनेजमेंट ऑफ नॉर्मल न्यूनेट्स में से भी आज हम डिस्कस करते हैं पर्टिकुलर एसेंशियल न्यूबॉर्न केयर। इसके ऑब्जेक्टिव्स निम्न प्रकार है। आवर फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव इज इंट्रोड्यूस नॉर्मल न्यूनेट, विच इज डिस्कस इन स्लाइड नंबर 7। आवर सेकेंड ऑब्जेक्टिव इज एनलिस्ट द कंपोनेंट ऑफ एसेंशियल न्यूबॉर्न केयर एट बर्थ एंड इट इज डिस्कस इन स्लाइड नंबर 8। नेक्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव इज एक्सप्लेन अबाउट प्रिपेयरनेस फॉर केयर एट बर्थ and it is discussed in slide number 9. Next is enlist the equipments required for newborn care and it is discussed in slide number 10. Next is describe the 5C asepsis of clean chain and it is discussed in slide number 11. Our next objective is explain about immediate care at birth and it is discussed in slide number 12. So these all are the objectives. And now let's start our topic with introduction. So, normal neonate. So, there are some characteristics of normal neonate. If these characteristics are fulfilled, then we can say that the neonate is normal. And if these characteristics are not fulfilled, then we can say the neonate as abnormal. So, following are the characteristics in which our first objective is birth weight. So, the normal birth weight for an Indian child is 2.5 to 3 kg. So, if the birth weight is greater than or equal to 2500 gram, then the neonate is called as normal neonate. Second thing is gestational weeks. And the normal gestational weeks for normal neonate is 37 weeks or more than 37 weeks but less than 42 weeks. So, if the gestation weeks is equal to or more than 37 weeks and below 42 weeks, then the neonate is called as normal neonate. Third is birth weight between 10 to 19th percentile on a standard intrauterine growth chart. And next characteristics is no need of resuscitation at birth if the baby is healthy and he or she can respire normally without any resuscitation, then the neonate is called as normal neonate. And absence of maternal illness or any adverse intrapartum events. And next characteristics is no postnatal illness such as respiratory distress, sepsis, hypoglycemia or polycythemia or requiring admission in neonatal unit. So these all are the characteristics of normal neonate. A neonate is the child from the day of the birth to 28 days of the life. This child or newborn is called as neonate, and after 28 days of life to 1 year, the child is called as infant. Now let's see about components of essential newborn care at birth. Our first component is preparedness, second immediate basic care, third prevention of hypothermia, fourth establishment of breastfeeding, fifth postnatal care, sixth prevention of infection, and last is detection of danger signs. So these all are the components of essential newborn care at birth. Now, let's see about preparedness for care at birth. So, for preparedness, proper newborn corner in delivery room and maternity operation theater should be present and go through maternal history like any chronic illness and other medications. Third thing we can do is anticipate high risk newborn. Fourth, trained health personnel should be present before delivery, and attending personnel should document the baby details, that is time of the birth, weight, gender and any other relevant information in all cases. So our first practice question number one is, birth weight of normal neonate is, our first option is greater or equals to 2500 gram, lesser or equals to 2500 gram, and third is greater or equals to 1100 gram. So our answer is first option, greater or equals to 2500 gram. As we had already discussed in slide number 6, that birth weight of normal neonate is greater or equals to 2500 gram. Now let's see about newborn care equipments. So for newborn care equipments, various equipments are required, like functional radiant warmer, basic resuscitation equipment of various sizes, bag and mask, and laryngoscope is required with size 0, 1, 2, and electrical or central suction device is required, oxygen supply is required, autoclaved linen, at least 3 pre-warm towel is required, single-use suction catheters of 10 or 12 FR should be required, feeding tubes are required, endotracheal tubes are required, syringes, needles, etc., and drugs like adrenaline, normal saline are required. So these all are the newborn care equipments. So now let's see about 5C asepsis concept of clean chain, in which first C stands for clean hands. That means the healthcare provider should wear gloves. Second C stands for clean surface. That means clean and sterile towel to dry and cover the baby. Third C stands for clean cord. That means the umbilical cord should be cut by a clean and sterile blade or scissor. Next C stands for clean tie or thread for cord, and we should not apply anything to the cord. Universal precautions should be applied in every delivery. So these all are about the asepsis concept of clean chain. Now let's see about immediate care at birth. So first thing we need to do immediately after birth is establishing airway, breathing, circulation and temperature. Second thing we can do is receive the baby in pre-warm linen in order to maintain the temperature. Third thing we can do is clamping cord by sterile blade or scissors. Next thing, gender identification by mother. And next we can do is taking anthropometry, wiping baby and transferring to another pre-warm linen. And next thing we can do is footprint on paper, identification tag to baby, vitamin K and other birth immunization like BCG, OPB, and clothing of the baby and put under radiant warmer or rooming in with mother. So these all are the things that we can do at the time of birth. Now let's see about timing and method of umbilical cord cutting and clamping. So the umbilical cord should be clamped after birth at 1 to 3 minutes. It should be tied with a clean thread, rubber band or a sterile cord clamp. Clamps should be applied 2 to 3 centimeter away from the base, stump should be away from the genitalia. The stump should be free of any applications like antiseptics and others. Now let's say about Apgar score. Apgar score should be recorded at 1 and 5 minutes. Apgar score has a limited value for initiating, stabilizing and prediction of subsequent outcomes. However, it does not predict mortality on short term and help defining the need for nursery admission. Now let's see our practice question number 2. Our second question is, umbilical cord should be clamped after birth at, our first option is 5 to 10 minutes, second option is 10 to 15 minutes, third option is 1 to 3 minutes, and the right answer is our third option, that is 1 to 3 minutes. As we had already discussed in slide number 12, that umbilical cord should be clamped after birth at 1 to 3 minutes. Now let's see about identification. So each infant must have an identity band with mother's name, hospital registration number, gender and date and time of the birth and birth weight of the infant. If footprints of baby is taken, then the quality of print should be good and hygiene to be maintained. The footprint should always be taken on the mother's case record also. Now let's see about identification of sick neonates. So like the characteristics of normal neonates, there are some characteristics of sick neonates. So let's see about the characteristics of sick neonates. First is baby birth weight. If birth weight is less than 1800 gram, then we can call the neonate as sick neonate. And second thing is babies with major congenital malformation. If babies is born with major congenital malformation, then we can call that baby or neonate as a sick neonates. Third, babies with asphyxia means who needed post resuscitation care, they are also called as sick neonates. And babies with breathing difficulty, so these are also called as sick neonates. Now let's see about cleaning the baby. So all the infants should be cleaned properly at birth with a clean sterile cloth to remove the blood clots and slash or meconium on the body. So we should not try and attempt to remove the vernix from the body by any means, as it can result trauma to the skin. Now let's see our practice question number 3. So Apgar score should be recorded at, our option is 2 and 6 minutes, 1 and 5 minutes, 3 and 8 minutes. Our correct answer is 1 and 5 minutes. So as we had already discussed in slide number 13, that Apgar score should be recorded at 1 and 5 minutes. Next we see weight recording. All the infants should be weighed at least within an hour of birth on a scale with at least 5 gram sensitivity. The weighing scale must be periodically calibrated. Single-use paper towel or a sterile cloth towel should be placed on the weighing scale beneath the infant. Now let's say about vitamin K and other immunizations. So vitamin K should be administered IM, that is intramuscularly, on the anterolateral aspect of the thigh using a 26 gauze needle, that is 1/2 inch and 1 ml syringe. Dose to be used is 0.5 mg for baby weighing less than 1000 gram and 1.0 mg for those weighing above than 1000 gram at birth. And other birth doses of BCG, OPB, hepatitis B should be immunized. Now let's see about prevention of hypothermia. So provision of warmth should be given to the newborn baby to prevent hypothermia. एंड इफ वार प्रोविजन ऑफ वार्म्थ इज नॉट गिवन टू न्यू बॉर्न बेबी देन इट कैन लीड टू हाइपोग्लाइसेमिया ब्लीडिंग डायथेसिस पल्मोनरी हैमरेज एसिडोसिस एपनिया रेस्पिरेटरी फेलियर शॉक एंड इवन डेथ. नाउ हियर यू कैन सी द मेथड ऑफ हीट लॉस. इन दिस डायग्राम थर्मल बैलेंस हैज बीन शोन एंड हाउ द थर्मल बैलेंस इज मेंटेन इन नॉर्मल नियोनेट. देर इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ कंडक्शन इवेपोरेशन कन्वेक्शन रेडिएशन. सो दिस इज द वे ऑफ थर्मल बैलेंस. नाउ लेट्स सी अबाउट मेजरमेंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर. सो फॉर मेजरमेंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर एक्सिलरी टेम्परेचर इज रूटीनली रिकमेंडेड सेफ हाइजीनिक एंड इज फॉर अर्ली डिटेक्शन ऑफ हाइपोथर्मिया. एंड रेक्टल टेम्परेचर वी कैन मेजर एंड इट इज रिकॉर्डेड इन मॉडरेट टू सीवियर हाइपोथर्मिया. मेजर्स कोर टेम्परेचर कैरीज रिस्क ऑफ परपरेशन. द कोर पेरिफेरल टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस ऑफ मोर देन 3.5 डिग्री सजेस्ट सेप्सिस. सो हियर वी कैन सी डायग्नोसिस ऑफ हाइपोथर्मिया बाय ह्यूमन टच. सो हियर आर टू डायग्राम्स. इन फर्स्ट टेबल और डायग्राम्स वी कैन सी डायग्नोसिस ऑफ हाइपोथर्मिया बाय ह्यूमन टच एंड सेकेंड यू कैन सी एक्सिलरी टेम्परेचर इन द न्यूबॉर्न. सो इन फर्स्ट टेबल यू कैन सी डायग्नोसिस ऑफ हाइपोथर्मिया बाय ह्यूमन टच. इन दिस यू कैन सी थ्री कॉलम्स. फर्स्ट इज फील बाय टच ट्रंक, सेकेंड फील बाय टच एक्सट्रीमिटीज एंड थर्ड इज इंटरप्रिटेशन. सो इफ फील बाय टच ट्रंक इज वार्म एंड फील बाय टच एक्सट्रीमिटीज इज वार्म देन आवर इंटरप्रिटेशन इज नॉर्मल. इफ फील बाय टच ट्रंक इज वार्म एंड फील बाय टच बाय एक्सट्रीमिटीज इज कोल्ड देन आवर इंटरप्रिटेशन इज कोल्ड स्ट्रेस. एंड इफ फील बाय टच ट्रंक इज कोल्ड फील बाय टच एक्सट्रीमिटीज इज कोल्ड देन आवर इंटरप्रिटेशन विल बी हाइपोथर्मिया. सो इन सेकेंड डायग्राम यू कैन सी नॉर्मल रेंज ऑफ एक्सिलरी टेम्परेचर इज 37.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड बिलो 36.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस इट इज कॉल्ड एज कोल्ड स्ट्रेस एंड बिलो 36.0 डिग्री सेल्सियस इट इज कॉल्ड एज मॉडरेट हाइपोथर्मिया एंड बिलो 32.0 डिग्री सेल्सियस इट इज कॉल्ड एज सीवियर हाइपोथर्मिया. सो कोल्ड स्ट्रेस मे बी द कॉज फॉर कंसर्न. मॉडरेट हाइपोथर्मिया इंडिकेट फॉर डेंजर एंड वी नीड टू वार्म द बेबी एंड सीवियर हाइपोथर्मिया इंडिकेट आउटलुक ग्रेट स्किल्ड केयर इज अर्जेंटली नीडेड. So now let's see about concept of warm chain. So warm chain is simply the set of 10 interlinked procedures which is carried out at birth and later so that it will minimize hypothermia in all the newborns. So we had already said that it is a set of 10 interlinked procedures. So our first procedure is warm delivery room. Like about 26 to 28 degrees Celsius. Second is warm resuscitation. Third is immediate drying of the baby. Next, skin to skin contact between baby and the mother. Next, breastfeeding. Next, bathing and weighing postponed if hypothermia is present. Then appropriate clothing and bedding. Next is mother and baby together, which is called as rooming in. And next is warm transportation. And last is training or awareness raising of healthcare providers. So this is the concept of warm chain. Now, prevention of hypothermia in delivery room. So in delivery room, hypothermia can be prevented by maintaining the delivery room temperature. So the delivery room should be warm at least 26 to 28 degrees Celsius and free from draft of other other instrument equipments and radiant warmer should be present, and it should be on for at least 20 minutes. Infant should be received in a pre-warmed sterile linen sheet and then dried thoroughly, including the head and face areas. Wet linen should not be allowed here to remain in contact with infant, and infant should be placed in skin-to-skin contact with mother immediately after birth on abdomen. So next thing is initiation of breastfeeding. So when to start breastfeeding? Breastfeeding should be initiated at the earliest possible time, irrespective of mode of delivery. That is within a half an hour in normal delivery and within 1 hour in cesarean section. Position of mother. Breastfeeding can be done in any position in which mother is comfortable. Next thing, we can see concept of golden hour. So by the end of first hour, the following should have been taken care of. First thing is maintenance of body temperature. Second thing, breastfeeding. Third, administration of vitamin K. And fourth is admission procedures. That means postnatal ward or any other ward. Now let's see about kangaroo mother care, which is also called as KMC. So it is simply a technique which is used in low birth weight babies, wherein the neonate is held skin to skin contact with mother or any other adult caretaker. So it should be given to all the low birth weight babies wherever and whenever possible for maximum duration of time and at least for 1 hour, because KMC helps in better thermal protection of neonates. Second thing is increasing milk production. Third is increasing the exclusive breastfeeding rates. And fourth is reducing respiratory tract and nosocomial infections. So these all are the positions for KMC. In the pictures, you can see that baby is placed skin to skin contact with their mothers. So during the KMC, we need to take some precaution regarding clothing and duration. That is, each session should be last for 1 hour, at least 1 hour, and provided for as long as possible. And we can encourage feeding during the kangaroo position. So kangaroo mother care can be used at all levels of care to prevent hypothermia in low birth weight babies. Next thing is rooming in. Rooming in, we had already discussed in earlier slide that we had to put mother and the newborn baby together so that proper bonding can be established between the mother and the baby. And there is no indication for separating a normal infant from the mother for routine observation in nursery, irrespective of the mode of the delivery. During initial couple of hours after birth, infants are awake and very active. So this time should be utilized for bonding and initiation of breastfeeding. Rooming in, why it is essential for establishing rooming in? Because it helps to establish and maintain breastfeeding. Second thing is baby sleep better and cry less. Third, reduced exposure to infection. Fourth, it helps mother to learn about her baby's feeding and behavior patterns. And last is reduces cost, because it does not require any procedure and any equipment, so it reduces cost. Next, we can see is clinical screening for malformation. So for this, we can inspect the cut end of the cord for number of vessels, that is 2 umbilical arteries and 1 umbilical vein. Second thing we can do is examine for esophageal patency. Third thing we can do is rule out anal atresia by inspecting the anal opening at the normal side. Next we can do is examine oral cavity to exclude cleft palate. and then we can examine the back for any swelling or anomaly. Next is care in postnatal wards. So after the mother and the baby is shifted to the postnatal wards, again some of the care should be given to them in order to take care of them, like maintenance of the temperature and exclusive breastfeeding, cord care, eye care, weight recording, evaluation for jaundice, passes of urine and stool, common developmental and physiological variations, danger signs, and counseling of the mother and the family. Exclusive breastfeeding. So, mother should be advised to exclusively breastfeed her infant on demand, feeding both during the day and night for at least 15 to 20 minutes. Second thing is one breast to be completely emptied during each feed before baby is put to the other breast. And third we can see is do not give any pre-lacteal feeds like gutti, tea, sugar water, jaggery, honey, etc. Next is colostrum. So colostrum is highly concentrated milk. It is produced during first 2-3 days and it has various anti-infective properties and it must be fed to the baby. Next is correct positioning for breastfeeding. So for correct positioning you can see in the diagram. So for this we need to wash our hands, be comfortable, relax your shoulder, and head and the body should be in a straight line. The whole body of the baby should be supported and the nose should be touched to the nipple and baby's tummy should be touched to the mother's tummy and mother's breast should be supported. So for this thumb should be placed on the top and fingers are below the breast. So this is about correct positioning of the breastfeeding. Next we can see attachment. So there are some signs which proves that there is good attachment to the breast. So first is mouth widely open, second chin touching the breast, third lower lip turned outwards, and fourth more areola visible above than below. If these all signs are present, then it indicates for good attachment of the baby to the breast. Next thing is effective suckling. So for effective suckling, infant show slow deep sucks, sometimes pausing. If not sucking well, then look for ulcers and white patches in the mouth. Now cord care. So umbilical stump should be kept dry and devoid of any applications. Bleeding may occur due to shrinkage of cord and loosening of the ligature. The nappy should be folded well below the umbilical stump, and umbilical discharge or redness or sepsis, it should be observed. Next, eye care. So eyes of the infant must be cleaned with sterile swab soap in normal saline or sterile water, clean from inner to outer canthus and use a separate swab for each eye. Next, oil applications. So oil application is a low cost traditional practice well ingrained in Indian culture. It prevents heat loss in preterm baby. However, exact data which suggests that what oil should be used for this purpose is still unknown. Next is bathing. So routine bathing in the hospital should be avoided in the view of risk of cross infection and hypothermia. The infant can be sponged as required. Infant can be bathed at home once discharged from the hospital, and traditional practices like putting kajal, surma, oil in the ears, giving pre-lacteal feeds like honey, sugar water should be discouraged. And no use of any powder, baby cream, and healthy newborn should be made to sleep on their own. Next, weight recording. So healthy term babies lose their weight during the first 2 to 3 days of life up to 5 to 10% of the birth weight, and weight remains stationary during next 1 to 2 days, and birth weight is again regained by the end of the first week. So delayed feeding and unsatisfactory feeding schedule may lead to excessive weight loss. Preterm experiences 2 to 3% weight loss daily up to a maximum of 10 to 15%. Any weight loss greater than 5% in a 24-hour period is abnormal, and preterm newborn should regain birth weight by 10 to 14 days of age. So normal average daily weight gain in term babies is around 20 to 30 gram per day. Next is vomiting. So many normal babies regurgitate or spit out some amount of milk, which is called regurgitation or vomiting. It is seen soon after the feeds, and it may be due to faulty technique of feeding or aerophagy. So proper advice regarding feeding and burping should be given to all the mothers. If the vomiting is persistent, projectile or bile stain, the baby should be further investigated. Now let's see about stool pattern. So any babies who has not passed meconium for 24 hours after birth need to be evaluated. So meconium is the first passed stool. So if baby do not pass his or her first stool for 24 hours, then it need to be evaluated. And second thing is transitional stool. So it is passed on the third and fourth day after birth. In this, the frequency is increased. It is often semi-loose and greenish yellow. It settles within 48 to 72 hours, and baby continues to feed well, and there is no need for treatment. Next we can see is excessive crying. So baby cry whenever he or she is hungry or is in discomfort. So discomfort may be due to the sensation of full bladder before passing urine, painful evacuation of hard stool, or mere swelling by urine and stools. If persistent crying is present, then it needs examination and detailed evaluation for inflammatory conditions and other causes. Now let's see about danger signs. So danger signs includes difficulty in feeding, convulsions, lethargy, that means movement only when stimulated, fast breathing, that is respiratory rate greater than 60 beats per minute, severe chest indrawing, temperature greater than 37.5 degrees Celsius or less than 36.5 degrees Celsius, and bleeding from any site, appearance of jaundice within 24 hours of age, or yellow staining of palm or soles. Further danger signs are failure to pass meconium within 24 hours or urine within 48 hours, persistent vomiting, poor feeding, excessive crying, drooling of the saliva or choking during feeding, respiratory difficulty, apneatic attack or cyanosis, sudden rise or fall in body temperature, evidence of superficial infections such as conjunctivitis, pustules, umbilical sepsis, that is redness at the base of the stump and discharge, oral thrush, etc. So now let's see about evaluation of jaundice. So all the infant must be examined for the development and severity of jaundice twice a day for first few days of life. For this, visual assessment should be done in daylight. So here some of the clinical criteria are given to assess the jaundice. So for this face, if there will be 4 to 6 mg per dl, upper trunk 6 to 8 mg per dl, lower trunk and thighs 8 to 12 mg per dl, arms and lower legs 12 to 14 mg per dl, palms and sole greater than 15 mg per dl. So in diagram you can see the criteria 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, वन इज फॉर फेस, टू इज फॉर अपर ट्रंक, थ्री इज फॉर लोअर ट्रंक एंड थाइस, फोर इज फॉर आर्म्स एंड लोअर लेग्स एंड फाइव इज फॉर पाम्स एंड सो. सो दिस आर अबाउट द एसेंशियल और इमीडिएट न्यूबॉर्न केयर. अगर आपको हमारा ये वीडियो पसंद आता है तो लाइक सब्सक्राइब एवं शेयर जरूर करें. इस वीडियो से रिलेटेड अगर कोई भी प्रॉब्लम हो तो डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में कमेंट करें. एंड थैंक यू.